Yesterday, we discussed organized and unorganized sector. Organized sector is that part of economy which generally follow rules and regulations marked by the government. Rules and regulations marked by the government and giving as the facilities, the more facilities to their employees. Such organized sector has generally giving the nature of a job as the permanent, and different number of the allowances are paid by the employer to their employees for the for their services. But in unorganized sector, such kind of facilities are not provided by the employer. But still, there are a large section of a population still dependent on unorganized sector. Because there are not adequate job opportunities generated in organized sector. Due to which the large number of a workforce dependent in an unorganized sector. That sector where exploitation of workers are more comparatively the organized sector. In unorganized sector, employees are exploited, economically exploited by the employers through less wages, through no provision of the allowances. Clear? So how to protect as a workers, how can we protect the workers in unorganized sector? So in unorganized sector, basically as a large section of that population, which comprises as the laborers, small marginal farmers, sharecroppers, artisans, weavers, blacksmiths, etc. All these are categorized under the unorganized sector. Where a large number of the workers, economically exploited. Their services are took for the more number of working hours and no provision of extra income. So a large number of workers which lost their jobs in the organized sector after the economic reforms of 1991 in organized sector. Why? Because due to the privatization, the policy of a privatization which opted through which a large number of a workforce which lies nearer to the age of their retirement, they removed from their services to the private sector. Clear? Then how can we as protect the workers in an unorganized sector? First, awareness. Workers, it should be as aware about their rights. The Constitution of India, the fundamental rights in Constitution of India, right to equality, gives opportunities to make their organizations. Workers can represent themselves in a form of their organizations, workers unions, through which they can work for their protection from the exploitative policies of employers. Clear? Second, increase in a number of job opportunities. If the government, there is as a situation when the government not having as the financial assets to develop the organized sector, develop the governmental sector factories. Under such circumstances, it starts to contribute in growth and development of economy through the shared base. Their example is a Saida school. Remember Saida school on a Patel Chowk. This is as the aided school. Aided school. Such kind of educational institutes which are basically work on a government's aid. Government has giving the aid. It is not fully as the government institute. Clear? Like as a government schools, it's not as looks like as a government school, but it follow the rules and regulations and supported by the financially supported by the government. Financially supported by the government. Second. Third, in unorganized sector, in unorganized sector, majority of the workers, they are belong from the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes, the backward classes of society, which are basically as socially discriminated. So to ensure the economic and social development, it is necessary to protect and support the workers in unorganized sector. And how is this possible? Through the government schemes, like as a Manrega, which ensure as a job opportunities for the socially and economically backward sections of society. Socially and economically backward sections of society. Fourth one, regular check on the functioning of unorganized sector. Government, it should initiate to regularly check upon the such number of firms or industries where the most possibilities of exploitation may occur. So in such number of the firms or industries, government, it should check upon such number of firms through which we can protect workers in unorganized sector. Is that clear? Through which we can protect the workers in unorganized sector. So till there, any doubts? Our next classification is based upon the ownership. Third classification of sectors based on ownership, which includes as public sector and private sector. Public sector and private sector. Any doubts still there? If anybody having any doubt, they can ask. Yes? Nobody? Public sector and private sector. Economic activities, it can be also classified on the basis of ownership. Ownership of assets. Such people also owns the assets, is responsible to the people for the delivery of services. In public sector means such number of firms, those firms or industries which are directly controlled, managed, and administered by the government and their agencies means some of the organizations are there which are supports government to obtain information from people, like NSSO. What it stands for, the NSSO? Khushi, raise your hand. 10th A. Khushi, what it stands for, the NSSO? NSSO. Last year in ninth standard, in last chapter, you read about it. NSSO.
So, National Sample Survey office.
Organization. Very good. Organization. National Sample Survey Organization, which has responsible for the conducting of a census. It is responsible for the census. And CSO, Central Statistical Organization. So when such type of agencies, these are the government supportive agencies, when government and their supportive agencies, they are controlled, managed and administered, the certain number of firms are known as the public sector firms. Public sector firms. These firms are generally work for the welfare, not for the profits. These firms are generally work for the welfare of society. Welfare of society. Welfare of society. For example, BSNL is a part of the public sector firm. Public sector firm. BSNL. Public sector firm. Indian Railways, Postal Services, Telegraph Services. All these are the postal services. These are the public sector firms. These are neither work for the profits. They work for the welfare of society. As opposite to it, in private sector, when such certain number of firms which are controlled, managed and administered by the individuals, it may be a one individual or a group of individuals. Group of individuals, they are, it is known as the private sector. When an individual or a group of individuals means as a company has responsible for the production of goods and services, known as the private sector. Private sector work for the profits. Private sector, it work for profits, not for the welfare of society. Not for the welfare of society. Clear? Example, Airtel. Airtel improving their services for what? To earn more profits, through which as a maximum number of customers, they have to join the Airtel. Same as the airlines, Indian Airlines earlier as managed by the public sector and other airlines which managed by the private sector like IndiGo, Lufthansa. So different are there, which are managed by the private sector, which are giving as a services, no doubt, they are giving as a better services, but for such services, they are charging as the more. Courier services, for example, courier services. It is as includes under the private sector. In the other side, as the public sector, postal services are there. Postal services are there, where the government has doing the work for the welfare of society. Except these two, there is a one more sector in economy, which is known as the joint sector. It is known as the joint sector. That joint sector has comprised by the public and private sector both. When public and private sector, both public and private sector, when government and private institutes, individuals, group of individuals and government agencies, they collectively work to supply goods and services in economy, goods and services in economy is known as the, they known as the joint sector. They are known as the joint sector. Clear? They are known as the joint sector. They are known as the joint sector. Example, Maruti Udyog Limited. Maruti Udyog Limited. Or another as a Reliance Industries at present. Reliance Industries at present, which basically has worked, Jio generally has worked in support of the government. In support of government. Punjab State Electricity Board is a part of a joint sector. This is as the part of joint sector. This is as the part of joint sector. Is that clear? joint sector. They are playing as a role in economy. These three sectors, public sector, private sector, and joint sector, these collectively are responsible to increasing the number of job opportunities, and increase in a number of production of goods. With production of goods in a larger quantities by public, private, and a joint sector, through which as the inflation controlled in our country. For example, let's take as an example, onions. Onions at the time of a rainy season, June, July, August, September. Throughout the year, private companies, they are purchasing as onions directly from the farmers and supplied towards the markets, During the rainy season, when the deficiency of onions occurred, under such circumstances, governments start to purchase such materials from the other countries to control over the inflation. The existence of a joint sector, it was resulted due to the correlation between of public and private sector. Correlation form in between of public and private sector. Because there are a certain number of goods which are generally used by the people for their survival. These are not directly given to the private industries, private firms. In 8th standard, you read about the public facilities. In which as a water, sanitation, supply of water and sanitation, such kind of a basic facilities are not managed by the private firms. Because if the government, it will given the such kind of the facilities to the private firms, then such private firms, they will charge the high prices for supply of such facilities. That's why the government, the municipal corporations in cities are responsible for supply of such services at free of cost. Such services, such basic services, which are very necessary for the survival, are provided by the government and their agencies in society. If the private firms, they start to manage the supply of water, then they will earn as the more profits by giving the materials to the those which can pay to it. And for the such sections which are economically backward and socially marginalized, they will face as the discrimination. So there are a large number of the activities which are the primary responsibility of government. The government must spend on these, not as the other, like as the private firms. Clear? And for the collaboration or a cooperation between the private and public sector, for this, as the joint sector emerged in society. In our society, where the public sector provide as the basic services like health and education at free of cost. In the other side, private firms, private organizations, they are also providing the same services at the high cost. Which is related to the growth of economy, development of society. Clear? This was our chapter, Sectors of Indian Economy. Any questions in your side? If anybody having any doubt, they can ask. This was our chapter, Sectors of Indian Economy. Yes, pay attention, everybody. There is a one change in a syllabus. Change in syllabus. Second chapter of geography deleted from syllabus. Second chapter of geography, forest and wildlife resource. Forest and wildlife resource deleted from the syllabus. The newer syllabus, it is updated in a CBSE site. cbse.nic.in. It is updated in a CBSE, www.cbse.nic.in. New curriculum for the current year, 2021-22, updated in CBSE site for all subjects. For all subjects. And in a part of a curriculum of social, which can be checked on a subject code of 087. 087 is a subject code of social science, through which you can check as the all the number of maps, those maps which will be asked in a which of the term one or term two. So it means in a first term there will be as the three chapters from geography: first resources, second water resource, third agriculture. From economics, only two chapters. From economics, two chapters. First, development and sectors of Indian economy. Total five chapters. These will assess in a term one examination. Is that clear? Any questions regarding the sectors of Indian economy? Sectors of national economy, sectors of Indian economy. If anybody having any doubt, they can ask. Till that time, let's we continue towards the exercise. First, I will call here the names. Such of the individuals raise their hands. Harshit Sani, Tensi. Second as the Ashin. Third, Gursevak. Fourth, Prabnu, raise your hands. So the Ashin, first blank is employment in the service sector dash increased to the same extent as the production. Has increased to the same extent as production. Workers, such students, they have to answer the other questions from question number six. Second blank as workers in the dash sector do not produce the goods. Tertiary sector, which produce as the services. Third, as the most of the workers in the dash sector enjoy job security. Organized sector, where the nature of a jobs are the regular. A dash proportion of laborers in India are working in the unorganized sector. Large proportion of laborers, which are generally not getting the jobs in an organized sector, they are forced to opt jobs in an unorganized sector. Fifth, cotton is a dash product and cloth is a manufactured product. Cotton is a natural product and cloth is a manufactured product. The activities in primary, secondary, and tertiary sectors are interdependent. They are interdependent. Now the such students which were called earlier, raise your hands again. Raise your hands. Ashin starts from you, MCQ first. The sectors are classified into public and private sectors on the basis of Ashin Kaur.
Yes, sir.
Answer. Very good answer. No answer. Ownership. Ownership of enterprises. Ownership means as a management. How they handled by the which of the authorities. Second, Harshit Sani.
Yes, sir.
Production of a commodity mostly through the natural processes is an activity in Harshit. Activity in dash sector.
The primary.
Production of commodity mostly through the natural processes is an activity in. Through the natural processes is a primary. Yes, Shivansh. Shivansh Agarwal. GDP is the total value of dash produced during a particular year.
Sir, all final goods and services.
All goods and services. You want to ask something, Agarwal?
No, sir. Sir, answer.
Thank you. Yes, next one. Dia. Dia from 10C. Dia from 10C. Or Disha. Dia, Disha, anyone from them? Dia or Disha? In terms of the GDP, okay, Prabhnoor. In terms of the GDP, the share of a tertiary sector in 2010 to the 11, it was. This question is based upon the. Yes. On this table, it is based upon this table. Prabhnoor,
what is 62
possible answer?
Between 50 to 60%.
50 to 60%. Question, it was in terms of the GDP, the share of the tertiary sector in 2010 and 11, it was 50 to 60% share in GDP, the total share. Sorry, these are the workers. Sorry. Yes, this one, 2010-11, it's more than, it's around as a 50 to 60%. Thank you, Prabhnoor. 50 to 60%. Next, question number 6. Do you think the classification of economic activities into the primary, secondary and tertiary is useful? Explain. Dia or Disha? Dia or Disha? Raise your hands. Nishtha, 10C. Nishtha, 10C. Raise your hands. If they are not there, Prabgun, raise your hand. Yes, Nishtha. Nishtha, tell me. Tell me about the non-economic activities first. Nishtha, non-economic activities with example.
Sir, there are different types of non-economic activities and they are divided into primary, secondary and tertiary.
No. My question is, can you tell me about what it means on non-economic activities with example? Non-economic activities.
Sir, non-economic activities are those which provide only services, not goods.
Services, not goods. It means that doctors which are providing as a service, doctors providing as a service is a non-economic activity. They are not earning the salaries. Unko income nahi milti. Doctors, lawyers, teachers.
No, sir. Means without any financial profit, they are providing the service. That activities are
very good.
Non-economic.
Certain number of activities through which when the income not generated is known as non-economic activities. Can you give me the example, Nishtha? Nishtha, example. Nishtha taught her brother is the non-economic activity because she didn't ask for the money from her brother. Clear, Nishtha? Your mother's preparing food for you. They are not earning the salaries. It's a part of a non-economic activity. Non-economic activity. Amritpal Singh doing work in a kitchen garden is a part of a non-economic activity, because that work, such services, such work which has done by the Amritpal for their family, it has not charged any salaries. Clear? These are the non-economic activities. Now come towards the question. So do you think the classification of economic activities into primary, secondary and tertiary is useful? Yes. Through which we can study about the production of various goods and services. Various goods and services produced in a different categories. Yes, Nishtha? What is your query?
No, sir, I only wanted to
put it your hand down. So interdependence of these sectors, it has supported for the growth and development of economy. Seventh question, for each of the sectors that we came across in this chapter, why should one focus on employment and GDP? Employment and GDP. Because this is as the criteria, the economic criteria, through which we can assess about the quality of population. Quality of population. Such economies where the GDP is more than the 10%. GDP is more than the 10%. And a high or a large number of employment opportunities are there. These economies are basically as the developed economies. These economies are the developed economies where per capita income is a higher. People are generally having the social and economic securities. Social and economic securities. If the person is not doing the work, governments are capable to feed their population without any services. Without any services. So could there be the other issues which should be examined? Yes, social indicators. Remember, first chapter, development, economics, UNDP's classifications, United Nations Development Program, which was targeted over economic as well as a social indicators like health and education. Health and education. Such issues, it should also as examined, because these issues are related with the growth and development of the human resource. Human resource. Make a long list of all kinds of work that you find adults around you doing for a living. In what way you can classify them? So as per the city area, city circumstances, we can classify these on the basis of a type of a goods, type of economic activities, primary, secondary, tertiary, primary, secondary, and tertiary. Primary activities which are generally occurred in outskirts of cities. In cities, these are the center of secondary and tertiary activities. Secondary and tertiary activities. How is the tertiary sector different from the other sectors? Explain tertiary service sector with their two kinds of services, basic services, infrastructure services. Basic services and infrastructural services. What do you understand by the disguised unemployment? Disguised unemployment, it is a state or a situation in which more people are employed as compared to demand. The inclusion and exclusion of a workforce from a working sites, the production sites, is not influenced the production. It is not influenced the production. Clear? Example, you can mark the example of agriculture fields. Next, as the distinguish between open unemployment and disguised unemployment. Who will answer it? Open unemployment and disguised unemployment. From 10th A, roll number 19. 19 roll number, raise your hand. 19 roll number from 10th A and 10C, both the classes. 19 roll number, 19. Himani Khanna, yes. Can you distinguish in between of open unemployment and a disguised unemployment?
Yes, sir. So in the open employment, this and the worker is ready to work, but he is unable to find work, and it can occur in any sector. But in the disguised unemployment, the worker is working, but he is removed, so the role does not fall.
Tell me in which of the sectors they are existed. They generally found in.
These are disguised unemployment mainly occurs in agriculture.
Which one, disguised or open?
Sir, can you please repeat the question?
Can you distinguish in between of a disguised and a open, as according to you, this disguised and open unemployment, they existed. They generally occur in a which of the sectors of economy? Disguised in primary and open unemployment found in primary and secondary. Primary and secondary. Why not as a tertiary? Because after the 1980s, due to the growth in a tertiary sector, the information technology based industries, they supported to generate as more job opportunities, and through which as more income also generates in it. So primary and secondary, clear? So this much for today. Rest we will continue on next week.